Oh, huh. Would you look at that? It's about time that I made a video about this library for .NET MAUI, which allows you to create calendars, events, delete them, update them, all with a couple of lines of code, super easy for iOS, Android, Windows, macOS. Let's just go check it out. Not too long ago, I made a video about a plugin that I'm working on, the Plugin.Maui.CalendarStore, which allows you to read all kinds of data from the calendars on your devices on iOS, Android, macOS, and Windows. And you could read all information about the calendars that are available for the user, the events that are on those calendars, but it was all read-only. And just before I started recording this video, I pushed a big red button and I released the first stable version of this library. But before I did, I added a bunch of functionality. So now it's not read-only anymore. You can not just get data from the calendar, but you can also put data into that calendar. So you can create calendars, you can create events, update events, delete events. You can do all kinds of crazy stuff with this. And it's about time that I reintroduce you to this library and show you what you can do with it. So let's hop over to my screen share and I will give you all the nitty-gritty details. Before we go over to Visual Studio and have a look how all of this works in code, let's have a quick look at the repository right here, because this has all the information on how to get started. Of course, it has all the code, so you can inspect what's going on under the hood, but we also have a description on, like, hey, what are the methods, how to get started, what to think of. So the documentation in air quotes, if you will. Now let's start with the most important thing, which is of course to start a repository right here. You can see I didn't even start it myself. Let's do that right now here on this video. That's how all great projects start. Let's start it yourself. And here I'm gonna go into the code in a little bit, obviously, but here if you scroll down, you can find where it is on NuGet. You will figure that out. And the API usage, this kind of follows the same pattern as the APIs inside of .NET MAUI for like the geolocation, the battery information and all that kind of stuff, all the sensors, everything that is known previously as the Essentials APIs. You can use it with dependency injection, or you can just use the static instance and call that. Now we're using potentially sensitive data, right? So we need a couple of permissions for those, for all the platforms. It's written down here what to actually implement and what to use for the permissions. And then we go over to see how to use it with dependency injection, how to use it straight from the static implementation. And we have a description of all the methods that are implemented with a brief description of what you can expect here. There's a couple of overloads to make your life easier. So obviously, if you find something, if you find any issue, any bug, please open an issue here. Maybe even better, open a pull request where you can actually, you know, contribute to this project. Now let's hop over. Well, actually, I'm going to use for this demo the sample app that is included here. So here under samples, if you click there, there is a solution file. And if you download the whole repository, open that solution file, you can see how it all works. So I have that loaded here in my Visual Studio. And here under the Solution Explorer, if you open that, you will find these two projects, the calendar store. So this has all the source and this sample app, right? So this is just a .NET MAUI app that's included. And this is actually how I developed this thing. So I have it hooked up. It's very easy to debug through the code. So if you want to contribute, this is basically it. Super easy to set up, super easy to see what's going on. So we have a calendar, calendar event, calendar attendees. So you can see if you go into these, find the same inline documentation that you can see in the IntelliSense right here coming up, and you will have all these data to work with whenever you're working with calendars and attendees and events. So we have all that, and then all the calendar store stuff here is the actual implementation, so you can see what's going on for each platform, how to do that. Now, if you're going to get started for yourself, this is going to be your project. You're going to right click, you're going to go to manage NuGet packages, which is disabled because my project was running. So I'm going to go here, manage NuGet packages, and you can find plugin.maui.calendar. And don't get the calendar one. Actually, the calendar one works perfectly together with my plugin because this is a visual control that shows you a calendar control. So that's super cool. Let me know down in the comments if you want to see a video on that. But you want to have this plugin.maui.calendarstore version 1.0 just released before this video. So you can install that on your project and you should be good to go. Let's start with the permissions first. So if you go into your app, then the platforms, you have Android, iOS, Mac, Catalyst. All of them need some kind of permission. So here, if you go to the Android manifest and you double click that, in Visual Studio, you'll get the graphical editor. So you get this and you can find the, I don't know, under the R, the read calendar right here, and under the W, you will find Write Calendar, so you check those and you should be good. For iOS and Mac Catalyst, make sure to do it in the two separate files if you're targeting those platforms. But the thing that you need to add is the exact same. So let's open this with the source editor. And you can see this key right here with a little description. And you want to make sure that it's something useful to your user, which explains why you need access to the calendar, so the user is assured that you're not doing any funny business there. So you got all that for Windows, same kind of thing. You need to do it in your package.appx manifest, so you can figure that out. From there, it depends on how you want to use it, right? If you want to go the route of dependency injection, you go into your MAUI program. You have to register your pages if you want to use constructor injection, and then you want to add, probably as a singleton, the calendar store plugin. So it's registered under an interface so that you can easily swap it out in test scenarios. And then you say calendar store.default, which will register that static instance. It will create one if it's not there, and register that in your dependency injection container. So we got all that. We'll show you how to use both, basically, so don't worry. And then from there, I have a couple of pages. So again, I'm using this project to actually develop the plugin. So every feature that's in here has a line of code in this sample app application as well. So if you're not sure how to do something, this is where you can find it. Let's start with calendars page. So here in this XAML, there's a label because, you know, everything that you're actually doing in the calendar here will reflect in your actual calendar on the device. So if you're using your personal device and you go deleting events with like, oh, this is just in this app, it's not. It's going to delete in your actual calendar. So make sure that you're aware of that. That's why I add this little label. And here for calendars, you can create one, load the calendars, and then I'm using data binding and everything that MVVM has to offer. So that's all in here. And I'm using this bindable layout on a vertical stack layout to actually show the calendars here. It's a very minimalistic design, just because I'm a horrible designer. So that's why I just say it's minimalistic so that it sounds more fancy than it actually is. And I'm showing the calendars. The delete is not implemented at this time because there is one platform, I'm looking at you, Android, which makes it super hard to delete calendars. So that's something that I still need to work on. Hopefully we'll get that done. But other than that, everything is implemented. So let's run this on Android, as I was already doing. Then it's going to deploy here to this device. This is an emulator, so this is not really my real data right here. And whenever we do, we'll see that two buttons with create calendar, load calendar. Let's load them first. And you can see that we have this, all kinds of calendars which try to tell us something, maybe that you want to subscribe to my channel. So please consider doing that. And we got all that, right? So you can update them. You can say, hey, please, I should have please with a couple of extra exclamation marks in here. You can say, hey, I want to update this calendar. Okay. And there we go. It's updated. So you can see that reflected here automatically. So the interesting thing about Android, all the other platforms will automatically assign a random color to the calendars that you create. On Android, they just say, nope, if you don't specify a color, we're not going to give a color. So that's also one of the functionalities that isn't maybe included in the sample. I need to work on that, is to specify a color when you create a calendar, because I've just taken to account the title here. So let's name this really please, so that you really please subscribe to my channel with all the calendars. And now it created this new one. And because I'm using data binding and all that kind of stuff, you will see it here in the code as well. So how does this work? Well, if we go to the code behind for this thing, then you can see that I have a little description with, hey, this uses dependency injection, and you can find that here. And you can see in the constructor here, I just inject that same iCalendarStore, and I put that in a read-only field on my class, and now I can just call on it. So if we scroll down here a little bit, and I go to this load calendars, you can see, hey, calendarstore.getCalendars. Boom, that's all you need to do to get a list of the calendars that I'm showing here inside of the app. The library will request the permissions, the runtime permissions, if needed. So I already deployed this app before times, and that's why it didn't request me the permissions this time, because I already allowed it another time. But if it wasn't allowed yet, then it will pop up automatically. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to manually check for permissions, unless you want to do it in another place inside your application, then it will still work, but it will come up automatically and prompt the user, and then go through whenever it's allowed or not, of course. So we got all that. Calendars.clear is going to do that list. And then for delete, I comment it out, it's still being worked on. And for the update, you can have that same thing, calendar store, update calendar, the ID to update, and the update result, which is the actual title that I'm taking in here. So that's how easy it is to work with this. And create, same thing, calendar store, create calendar. You will actually get the ID back from the created calendar, also for events. So you can automatically start working with that ID if you need it in a follow-up operation. So here you can do var new ID, and you can work with that new ID, which will be the new ID of the calendar that has just been added. So we got all that. Now let's move on to events. And in events, we are kind of do the same thing, but now we can do a couple of more things, right? So the XAML is not really that interesting. I list all the properties right here. Again, minimalistic designs. I have a button to update and delete, so we do all that. And let's have a look at the code behind here. Because maybe, so this page uses the static calendar store.default class. So I think I might be mixing some things here. Let's see what we're doing. Delete. So here you can actually see like, hey, we're checking some things, of course, like, hey, I couldn't determine the event because this should never happen. Actually, we display a little prompt like, hey, are you really, really sure? And then you can say we do calendar store.default.delete event. So you can just call on that static instance as well. Or I could have just chosen here in the constructor to also say, hey, I want to have that I calendar store in here and follow that same pattern as well. Totally up to you how you want to implement that. Now, looking at this at runtime, we go over to the events tab here. I also need some icons maybe. I can do load events. I'm not sure if there's actually in here something. No, not yet. So I can create an event and it will come up with a little create form, select the calendar that I want to add this event to. So let's do it YouTube, event title, subscribe. I'm not sure if you're getting the message here, but I really want you to subscribe. Please do, which is the description, the location, Earth, and you can set the start date, start time, end date, and all that kind of stuff, right? So all the things that you need here. You can mark it as an all-day event, and then you can say save, and it will save it to the selected calendar. So now it will automatically update, and it will show you this event, title, subscribe, calendar ID. So it doesn't show you the name, but the calendar ID is 6. So if we go here, you will see that same name, ID 6. Name is YouTube, so it's saved to that calendar. Start date, end date, everything is here. If I update, I go here again. I made the select calendar grayed out for now. So because updating the ID of the calendar isn't really great on all platforms. So if you want to move it between calendars, you probably want to delete it and recreate it somewhere else. But all the other things you can update. So if I add a 1 to everything here and I do save again, it will update that and it will have all the 1s in here. You can see that. And I can delete it, of course, again, and the event will be removed. So all of that code is available here in this sample, and you can implement that in your own application as well and work with all this calendar data in your .NET MAUI app. And what do you think? Version 1 of the Calendar Store plugin? Let me know down in the comments if this is something that you're going to use and what for. Let me know what else you want to see about this or anything else. I highly recommend that you also check out the video where I go more into reading actual events from the calendar, which I made a video about earlier. And I'll be seeing you for my other videos. Ta-ta!